सो दिस किसमें? यस ऑब्वियसली. सो यू दिस आर सम ऑफ द इम्पैक्ट्स. क्वेश्चन इम्पैक्ट नहीं पूछा है, क्वेश्चन इज ब्रिंग आउट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन श्रिंकिंग हिमालयन ग्लेशियर्स एंड वॉट आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ द क्लाइमेट चेंज इन इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट. दैट इज यू हैव टू टेल दैट वाई द हिमालयन ग्लेशियर्स आर श्रिंकिंग एंड अदर क्लाइमेट चेंजेस इन इंडिया. सो ब्रिंग आउट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन श्रिंकिंग ऑफ द ग्लेशियर्स एंड द सिम्टम्स ऑफ द क्लाइमेट चेंज. सो वॉट आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ द क्लाइमेट चेंज. अगर आपने इसमें से कुछ भी पॉइंट लिखा है एक्सेप्ट मोर फ्लडिंग, मोर कोस्टल सबमर्जेंस, वाटर स्कार्सिटी, टू सम एक्सटेंट द चेंजेस इन द ईस्टर्ली जेट स्ट्रीम, टू सम एक्सटेंट हीट वेव्स, क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न कहाँ चेंज हुआ है? हुआ नहीं है ना. उन्होंने पूछा है ब्रिंग आउट द रिलेशन. सो अदर देन दैट इफ यू राइट इंटरलिंकिंग ये सब तो आंसर में मार्क्स नहीं मिलेंगे. यू हैव टू टेल व्हाट आर व्हाई द ग्लेशियर्स आर चेंजिंग ड्यू टू विच सिम्टम्स ऑफ द क्लाइमेट चेंज. दैट इज द राइज इन द सी लेवल, ग्लेशियर्स आर श्रिंकिंग. चेंजेस आर द इन द फ्लो ऑफ अ रिवर, दैट मीन्स द ग्लेशियर्स आर चेंजिंग. सो आई विल गिव यू अ मॉडल आंसर फॉर दिस, सो यू कैन टेक डाउन. बिकॉज ये कब के पेपर का था, कब फोटो भेजा? ये आज ही के पेपर में है शायद. सो यस, सो वी विल राइट ऑल दिस थिंग्स. सो बट आई एम गिविंग यू आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. यू सी व्हाट इज द डिमांड ऑफ द क्वेश्चन? डिमांड ऑफ अ क्वेश्चन इज सिम्टम्स ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज एंड द इम्पैक्ट ऑन द ग्लेशियर्स. The question is not asking the impact of the glacier melting on India. We have just listed out the impact of the melting of the glacier. So they are asking you what are the symptoms of climate change. So इसमें thunderstorms आएगा? Yes. इसमें heat waves आएगा? Yes. Forest fires? Yes. So these are the symptoms of the climate change. Recurrence of El Nino like phenomena? Yes. So you can take down. In the recent years, due to more burning of the fossil fuels, related global warming. फिर से चला गया. एंड द रिलेटेड ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, द हिमालयन ग्लेशियर्स आर मेल्टिंग एट अ फास्टर रेट. इट शुड ऑलवेज बी सपोर्टेड बाय डेटा. बिटवीन द ईयर 1970 to 2000, 9% of the ice volume was lost. 9% of the ice volume was lost. While between the year 2003 to 2009, between the year 2003 to 2009, 170 gigatons of water. Anybody carrying today's newspaper? 170 gigatons of water was lost. 170 gigatons of water was lost. 170 gigatons of water was lost. It is said that the melting of glaciers. The melting of glaciers. From the third pole region. आज के पेपर में वो आर्टिकल में ये वर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट है, थर्ड पोल रीजन विल हैव मेजर इंपैक्ट ऑन इकोनॉमी इकोसिस्टम एंड डेमोग्राफी. मैं ये भी वर्ड यूज़ कर सकता था, इकोनॉमी एनवायरनमेंट एंड पॉपुलेशन. वी हैव यूज द बेटर वर्ड्स डेमोग्राफी. द सिम्टम्स ऑफ द मेल्टिंग ऑफ ग्लेशियर. इकोसिस्टम में सब कुछ आ गया. द सिस्टम्स ऑफ द मेल्टिंग ऑफ द ग्लेशियर. द सिम्टम्स ऑफ द मेल्टिंग ऑफ द ग्लेशियर due to climate change are already seen and they can be listed as below. This is the approach of the answer. You have to list the symptoms of the climate change, can be listed or are as given below, can be listed as below. First, frequent floods in Brahmaputra, Kosi and Kashmir during the pre-monsoon season. किसी ने लिखा है ऐसे में? Anybody who has attempted this question? What you have written? But have you approached the answer in this way? That is, what are the symptoms? We have written. Show me the answer after the class. क्या लिखा? So during the pre-monsoon season, which shows more melting of ice is taking place due to high heat. Second, The per unit electricity production in many Himalayan dams have dropped by 1 to 3%. 1, 2, 3%. ये नहीं, 1, 2, 3 नहीं, 1, 2, 3%. रिमेंबर वन जनरल रूल, 1% डिक्रीज इन द फ्लो मतलब 3% डिक्रीज इन द हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर प्रोडक्शन. इफ द वाटर डिक्रीजेस बाय 1%, फ्लो ऑफ वाटर रिड्यूसेस बाय 1%, हाइड्रो इलेक्ट्रिक पावर प्रोडक्शन डिक्रीजेस बाय 3%. फ्लो कब होगा ज्यादा? फ्लो होगा ज्यादा ओनली ड्यूरिंग द प्री मॉनसून. बट विंटर्स में फ्लो कम हो जाएगा उनका, तो ये ओवरऑल डिक्रीज हो जाएगा, पूरे साल का तो डिक्रीज होगा। इनिशियली फ्लो बढ़ेगा बट बाद में फ्लो कम हो जाएगा। इरोशन भी ज्यादा होगा। थर्ड, देयर इज फ्रीक्वेंट फ्लक्चुएशंस इन द रिवर रेजिम और रिवर फ्लो। देयर इज फ्रीक्वेंट फ्लक्चुएशन इन द रिवर रेजिम, इन द ब्रैकेट रेजिम मतलब सीजनल फ्लो, सीजनल फ्लो, रिवर रेजिम, रेजिम का मतलब है सीजनल फ्लो। ड्यू टू इंक्रीज्ड मेल्टिंग रिलेटेड विथ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग, स्टडीज एट फरक्का बराज कहां पे है फरक्का बराज, हैव शोन दैट दो द शॉर्ट टर्म दो इन द शॉर्ट टर्म velocity and the flow of river Ganga has increased, though in the short term velocity and the flow of river Ganga has increased and the flow of river Ganga has increased there is also increase in there will there is also increase in erosion There is also increase in erosion and siltation. Siltation is deposit of silt. Silt is the sediment that is brought by the river. Siltation of the in the low-lying coastal regions. This is our model answer. Obviously, ये technical थोड़ा ज़्यादा होगा, but आप अपने खुद के वर्ड्स में भी ये पॉइंट्स लिखोगे तो इट विल बी मोर देन इनफ। द सिल्टेशन सिल्टेशन अगर ज्यादा होगा फ्लडिंग ज्यादा होगी, रिवर विल बिकम मोर ब्रेडेड। इन द लॉन्ग रन This rivers may become seasonal. Thus increasing international water disputes in already sensitive geopolitical region. हिमालय का इंक्रीज एंड रिवर से क्या लेना देना है? स्नोफॉल के लिए मॉइस्चर तो चाहिए, मॉइस्चर ग्लोबल वार्मिंग में मिलेगा कब? स्नोफॉल कब होगा? मॉइस्चर चाहिए तो मॉइस्चर, ये किलिमंजारो जो हम पढ़ते हैं इट इज द ग्लेशिएटेड, आज कितना बचा है 1912 के बाद जो किलिमंजारो, हम तो बहुत छोटा इसमें पड़ता है, किलिमंजारो इज द मोस्ट ग्लेशिएटेड माउंटेन ऑफ यूरोप ऑफ अफ्रीका, बट 1912 के बाद 94% ऑफ द ग्लेशियर इन द किलिमंजारो हैज मेल्टेड एंड ओनली 6% इज रिमेनिंग. देयर आर न्यूमरस पीक्स विच आर एट अ ग्रेटर हाइट. उसमें हाइट के कारण ग्लेशियर है, बट ग्लेशियर डज नॉट मीन रिवर. ग्लेशियर तो छोटा भी हो सकता है. 75 किलोमीटर्स का ग्लेशियर, सियाचिन ग्लेशियर, इज फीडिंग अ वेरी टाइनी रिवर नुब्रा. इट इज नॉट इनफ टू सस्टेन द माइटी रिवर लाइक इंडस और गंगा. गेटिंग दिस? नेक्स्ट. कौन सा? वन एंड सिल्टेशन जनरली डज नॉट मीन फ्लडिंग. सिल्टेशन हैज लार्ज स्केल इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट्स. सिल्टेशन विल रिजल्ट इन टू रिवर क्रॉसिंग द चैनल इवन ड्यूरिंग द ड्राई सीजन. ब्रह्मपुत्र फ्रिक्वेंट फ्लडिंग. सिल्टेशन विल रिजल्ट इन टू क्लोजिंग डाउन ऑफ द पोर्ट्स ऑन द ईस्टर्न कोस्ट. बट हम इतना सारा इस आंसर में लिख नहीं सकते क्योंकि डिमांड नहीं है. सिल्टेशन विल रिजल्ट इन टू कमिंग ऑफ डिपॉजिट्स इन द फार्म्स. मिट्टी अगर बहुत ज़्यादा क्लेई बन जाएगी बिकॉज ऑफ सिल्ट, देन द क्रॉप्स कैन नॉट ग्रो. सो ये बहुत ज़्यादा होता है ड्यू टू सिल्टेशन. सिल्टेशन विल रिजल्ट इन टू सॉइल डिग्रेडेशन. सिल्टेशन का एक ही आस्पेक्ट है फ्लडिंग. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. From 2012 onwards, there is increase in the dry days. Next point, fourth point. There is increase in the dry days. Dry days. During both. Southwest monsoon and the winter season. During both southwest monsoon and winter season. During both southwest monsoon and winter season. In fact, the 2017-18 winter, 17-18 ka winter, not 18-19 ka winter. We are in the 18-19 ka winter. Was the driest winter after 1901, driest winter after 1901. This shows there is greater loss of moisture. There is greater loss of moisture due to global warming. And thus decreasing snowfall in the Himalayas. As well as increasing heat waves and dust storms in the Great Plains of India. Dust storms in the Great Plains of India. कौन से साल में सबसे ज़्यादा dust storm थे? इसी साल में. Why? Because winters were not severe. As the winters were not severe, what happened? The ground was not sufficiently cooled. Winters में the ground remained warmer. Remember last year का winter and this winter. So last year के winter में December में sweater की ज़रूरत ही नहीं थी. But this year we are wearing the sweaters. इसलिए last year it was heavily polluted. इस साल भी pollution है. But pollution has been removed. So, अभी भी अगर आपने फोन में देखा तो दिल्ली की एयर इज वेरी अनहेल्दी बट इट इज नॉट टॉक्सिक. अनहेल्दी है बट इट इज नॉट टॉक्सिक. थकान होती है अभी भी बट आंखें नहीं जलती. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? सो ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम this shows. Now, last year, what happened? Last year, because there was no cooling of the ground, so when the winters went away and the summers came, dust was not settled. Barish will consolidate the dust. It will take away the excess dust. And this dust, which was not settled very properly, the ground became so hot ki ye dhool upar ud gayi, jisko kehte hai dust storms. Understanding this? Is saal, thankfully, we have heavy rainfall. Kyun? Because global warming kam hua hai? No. This year is a La Nina year. La Nina year. This year is a La Nina year, and therefore we have good amount of moisture in the world. Next point. The submergence of coastal regions. Especially Bangladesh. And the Sundarbans area of India. Why is Sundarbans famous? सबसे पहले Sundarbans means tiger और mangroves, world's largest mangroves, and then उसमें tigers. Is it a world heritage site, Sundarbans? Is it a Ramsar site? Exception है. It is not a Ramsar site. It is a world heritage site. The submergence of Sundarbans and Bangladesh is a testimony. To rise in the sea level. Due to the melting of glaciers. Which is promoting large scale illegal migration from Bangladesh in eastern India, affecting resource utilization and demography. बट उसका अपने आंसर से कोई संबंध नहीं पढ़ा था. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. नहीं, यू आर राइट इन दैट पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, आई एम गिविंग यू ऑल द पॉइंट्स. सिम्टम्स क्या क्या है क्लाइमेट चेंज के? इंक्रीजिंग अमाउंट ऑफ ट्रॉपिकल साइक्लॉन्स in the Bay of Bengal and incidences of tropical cyclone even during the winters. Example kaun sa? is an indication of is an indication of global warming, is an indication of global warming affecting is an indication of global warming affecting the Himalayan glaciers. Conclusion: there is an urgent need at international level of reducing global warming by adopting clean development mechanisms at national, sub-national, and local levels. A common conclusion is, else, the largest source of fresh water, fertile alluvial soils will disappear by 2100, having regional as well as international consequences by 2100. See, aaj ke paper mein se humne do hi cheez uthai hai, ek third fold pole world third pole, and dusra ki 2100 tak most of the glaciers will be melting. So this is how you should use some of the facts. Baki aaj ke isme kuch factual data nahi, usko ratte nahi baithna hai, understand karna hai, and you have to understand how you are going to use that in writing an answer. Fine. So what is this third pole? What is third pole? Not only Himalayas. How many poles are there? Two poles, North Pole and South Pole. What, Arctic and Antarctic? Kya hai wahan pe? Glacier. But are these the only glaciated regions of the world? No. There are glaciers even in Himalayas, Andes, Rockies, even in the tropics, in the high mountains. So ye mountainous glaciers ko kaha jata hai third pole. So ye aa sakta hai prelims mein, recently the third pole is in the news. What it is? So these are the glaciers in the high mountains of the world are known as third pole. Glaciated regions of the high mountains are known as third poles. Himalayas, Alps, Rockies, Andes, koi bhi tropic, subtropical region outside poles is third pole. Fine with this. So try writing the answer on your own. Fir se ek baar ye padke. Ab last question. Mumbai, Delhi and Kolkata are the mega cities of the country, but the air pollution is much more serious problem in Delhi compared to the other two. Why is this so? Kya kya likha hai? So what will come in the geographical location? Landlocked. So what happens due to landlocked? Sabse pehle landlocked nahi word aana chahiye. Word aana chahiye, this is a continental effect. And because of the continental effect, this Delhi experiences winters. And because of the winters, air subsides, bringing down the pollution. Properly point-wise job. Second, geographical location. Because of the, so what we have in Delhi, extreme. And winters aata hai, which subsides the air, bringing down the pollutants that is present in the air. Second, due to geographical location, there is absence of land and sea breeze. Which removes the pollutants from the other cities. Baki ke isme you have to say that it will remove the pollutant. Third, because of the geographical location, there is a predominance of dry air having aerosols in suspension. इसलिए एयर पोल्यूशन इज वेरी बॉम्बे एक्सेट्रा में एरोसॉल्स नहीं है एयर में. वाई? बिकॉज दे बिकम ह्यूमिड एंड दे सेटल डाउन. वहां पर वाटर पोल्यूशन ज्यादा है, यहाँ पे एयर पोल्यूशन ज्यादा है. विच इज मोर डेंजरस? एयर पोल्यूशन. बिकॉज वाटर यू कैन फिल्टर, एयर में हम आर ओ नहीं लगा सकते या कुछ मशीन नहीं लगा सकते नाक पे. अभी जाना सुपर मार्केट में, ऑलरेडी ऑक्सीजन मिनी सिलेंडर्स आने लग गए इंडिया में. That is 500 rupees में मैंने अपोलो में देखा कल. तो एयर पोल्यूशन इतना ज़्यादा है, एक ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर खरीद लो, जब बहुत थकान लगी तो ऑक्सीजन मुँह के अंदर एंड यू विल बी फिल. सो दिस इज वॉट इज वी आर डूइंग टू आवर सिटीज. सेकेंड, वॉट इज द सेकेंड? इट इज सराउंडेड बाय एग्रीकल्चरल रीजन्स. सो उससे क्या होगा? सराउंडेड बाय एग्रीकल्चरल, एग्रीकल्चरल प्लेन्स एंड देयरफॉर टू थिंग्स हैपन हियर. वन, देयर इज ऑलरेडी डोमिनेंस ऑफ पोलन्स इन द एयर, क्रॉप से क्रॉप पोलन्स. एंड सेकेंड, यहां पे देयर इज अ stubble burning, not here, in entire Great Plains including Pakistan, which is brought by subtropical westerly jet. Explain karna padega, 200 word mein pucha hai. This is your past year question. Dust hai na, pollen. Pollen will cause pollution, aerosols. नहीं, क्योंकि अगर वो लिखोगे तो विंड आती है, विंड तो शुड रिमूव द पोल्यूशन. विंड विंड इज देयर. यहाँ पे ज्योग्राफिकल लोकेशन में यहाँ पे आएगा, टेम्परेचर इन्वर्जन होता है यहाँ. एनी अदर पॉइंट? वो तो इंडस्ट्रियल बूम. इंडस्ट्रियल बूम यहाँ ज्यादा है या चेन्नई या मुंबई में ज्यादा है? वेहिकुलर पोल्यूशन दिल्ली है, क्यों मुंबई में नहीं है वेहिकुलर पोल्यूशन? तो व्हाट इज द यूनिक पॉइंट रिगार्डिंग दिल्ली? दिल्ली हैज twice the number of vehicles as compared to all the vehicles of other metros in India. जितनी चेन्नई में है plus जितना कोलकाता में है plus जितना मुंबई में है plus जितना पुणे में है into two times is the DL registered vehicle. इसमें we are not counting HR registered, we are not counting RJ registered और UP registered जो आती जाती रहती है दिल्ली में. दिल्ली में 1.1 करोड़ व्हीकल्स है. ये पॉपुलेशन होता है एक बहुत सारे सिटीज का एंड कंट्रीज का. सो दिस मच नंबर ऑफ व्हीकल्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड ऑब्वियसली व्हीकुलर पोल्यूशन इज वेरी हाई बिकॉज ऑफ नंबर ऑफ व्हीकल्स ऑफ मुंबई, इक्वेशन मत लिखना एग्जाम में, प्लस कोलकाता प्लस चेन्नई इंटू टू इज द नंबर ऑफ व्हीकल्स इन दिल्ली. सो यू कैन राइट अबाउट द फोटोकेमिकल स्मॉग हियर. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? फोर्थ, थर्मल पावर प्लांट कहाँ है दिल्ली में? बदरपुर. क्योंकि ट्रांसपोर्ट नहीं है ना, अभी आई है मेट्रो. पहले सडन माइग्रेशन, दैट इज दिल्ली. मुंबई का कैपेसिटी ख़त्म, चेन्नई का कैपेसिटी ख़त्म, डिक्लाइन ऑफ कोलकाता एज अ सिटी बिकॉज ऑफ लेफ्टिस्ट टेंडेंसीज, एवरीथिंग, एवरीवन स्टार्टेड कमिंग टू दिल्ली. आफ्टर 2004 कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर गॉट बेस्ट इन इंडिया. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस लार्ज नंबर ऑफ जॉब्स वेयर क्रिएटेड. दिस इज अ प्लेन रीजन. यहाँ पे रोड कंस्ट्रक्शन, मेट्रो कंस्ट्रक्शन इज नॉट डिफिकल्ट एज कम्पेयर टू द अदर. बाकी ये तीनों सिटीज जो है, कोलकाता इज इन द डेल्टा, मुंबई इज बैकग्राउंड ऑफ वेस्टर्न घाट्स, चेन्नई द बैकग्राउंड ऑफ ईस्टर्न घाट्स. सो एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस वो सिटीज आइसोलेटेड है, बट दिल्ली का ये रीजन पूरा एक्सपांड होते गया. इन फ्यूचर NCR विल बी राइट अप टू, अभी कहाँ तक है NCR? सोनीपत, पानीपत. In future, the NCR region will go right up to Jaipur. Matlab high speed metro will connect you from Delhi to Jaipur. There will be people who will be migrating from Jaipur to Delhi on daily basis by high speed trains. That is the future of this region. Ye ban jayega India ka first megalopolis, jo abhi tak India mein nahi hai. Shanghai, Beijing jaise connect hua hai, waise ye ho jayega over the period of time. Already government ko pata hai that this region will have so much sustained growth ki yahan pe there will be large scale migration. So government has already started developing Gwalior, already started developing Amritsar, started developing Jaipur, and have started developing Rai Bareli in the north as counter magnets ki rather than people coming to Delhi, they go and settle in Jaipur, they go and settle in Amritsar, they go and settle in the Gwalior region as counter magnets, because Delhi is going to experience the biggest urban growth and it will be one of the biggest cities in the world in the recent next 20-30 years. So aise nahi hota Delhi bekar ya ye. China humse bhi zyada polluted tha. Beijing today it is one of the cleanest city. London ki river Thames was even bad than Yamuna. So it is all based on the people attitude, logo ke attitude of how they want to change the city. So koi city buri ya koi city achhi nahi hoti. It is based on the infra, it is based on the environment and based on the people. Raste bahut bade hai fir bhi traffic jam, you will find unique only in this city. Itne zyada to बॉम्बे में हाईवे भी नहीं है जितना बड़ा यहाँ पे लेन्स है. गो एंड सी द हाईवेज इन मुंबई, बट ट्रैफिक जाम कम क्योंकि रेड लाइट बहुत ज़्यादा है बिकॉज लेन डिसिप्लिन. सो ऑल दिस आर देयर. सो यू इंक्लूड दिस पॉइंट हियर ऑल्सो, फाइन, यू इंक्लूड दिस पॉइंट बिकॉज ये पॉइंट जनरली मिलेगा नहीं. और ये क्वेश्चन ऐसे आते रहते हैं, ऐसे नहीं कि ये क्वेश्चन आ गया तो फिर से नहीं आएगा. ये क्वेश्चन हमेशा आता रहेगा, सिर्फ लैंग्वेज चेंज होगी. This question, fine? What will be the conclusion of this? Solution can be, as urbanization is increasing in Asia and India, there is urgent need for sustainable development of the cities. Otherwise, cities will become non-livable in the future. Aisa solution do, sustainable development.
It is being recognized by both government and private players. So they are coming with innovative ideas.
हाँ, कोई भी solution हो सकता है. Yes, yes, you can. You can even write the conclusion that nowadays, from 2018 onwards, current affairs mein, 2018 onwards, Delhi, the same levels of pollution as if have increased in the coastal cities also, which shows that there is urgent need to develop integrated mass rapid transit system. You can take down. Integrated mass rapid transit system. Yes. Integrated mass rapid transit system, which will include mass rapid transit system, which will include fast trains. ब्रैकेट में बुलेट ट्रेन्स भी लिख सकते हो. बिटवीन टू सिटीज डेडिकेटेड साइकिलिंग एंड वॉकिंग लेन्स एंड एफिशिएंट सिटी पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट. Efficient city public transport. लिखा है efficient city public transport. That is, for example, USA, or for example, Japan, for example, China. People move from one place to another, the cities which are 300, 400 kilometers apart in half an hour, in 1 hour. So उनको जाके वहाँ पे settle होने की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ती. They can move on the daily basis. मेरे को रोहिणी से यहाँ आने के लिए 1 घंटा लगता है, जो 16 किलोमीटर है, और चाइना में 300 किलोमीटर कवर करने के लिए 1 घंटा लगता है. सो अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस, सो दैट इज द फास्ट. इसीलिए तो हम हाइपरलूप और बुलेट ट्रेन ला रहे. यू मे क्रिटिसाइज द प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट. कहाँ पर ई रिक्शा तो है. उसके बाद वाई मेनी पीपल डोंट प्रिफर मेट्रो. They come down and then they have to walk or drive for next 1.5 kilometer. So, वहाँ पे there has to be a auto लेना पड़ता है. So, there has to be last mile connectivity. उसमें क्या आ सकता है? Metro से के बाद there can be pods, जो अभी बॉम्बे में develop हो रहे. Pods, monorail. Metro between the larger regions and the smaller regions में monorail or pods. Rapid metro is still metro. What is? Point to So for, don't argue here, you have to give solutions. It has to be pod. Third, electric vehicles. Fourth, sabse important, cycling lanes, walking lanes. Not like this signal. So, fine with this? So write this paper again, जिन्होंने लिखा है और जिन्होंने नहीं लिखा है, लिखो ये paper and submit it. At least, because ये इतना open-ended है कि इसमें से कोई भी question repeat हो सकता है. Ma'am, discuss कर लेंगे. See, in the end, ये solution नहीं लिख सकते हम, but what is the biggest pollutant in India is population. बट हम नहीं लिख सकते कि वी रिक्वायर्ड मास डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ पॉपुलेशन. यस सो व्हाट इज द ओरोग्राफिक रेन. ओरोग्राफिक रेन इज द एनी रेन दैट इज कॉज्ड ड्यू टू द माउंटेन बैरियर. Now, what is this? What are the characteristics of an orographic rain? Sabse pehle, the most important characteristics is the mountain should lie perpendicular to the direction of the wind. Therefore, हमने कहा mountain barrier, not just mountain. It is caused due to the mountain barrier. Why? Because if the mountain is lying perpendicular to the direction of the wind is forced to rise up. When it rises upwards, it cools. adiabatically condenses and gives heavy rainfall on the side which faces the wind, and this side is known as windward side. This side is known as an windward side, while the other side, which is known as a leeward side of a mountain, on other hand, experiences less rainfall or drought like conditions or even deserts, depending upon the height of a mountain. Agar height of a mountain is more like Western Ghats, medium sized mountains, then the leeward side will be drought prone region of India. Aa jata hai yahi se prelims ka question, why there is a narrow strip running parallel to the Western Ghats that is drought prone. Answer is leeward side of the Western Ghat. So this effect of a mountain, ki leeward side mein there is less rainfall, is what is known as an rain shadow effect of a mountain.
Sir, isme height.
When the height of a mountain is greater, ek to winds cannot cross that, or even if the winds cross that, they are forced to come down from a greater height. When they are forced to come down from the greater height, there will be more heating like Chinook. And more heating, the more humidity capacity, and therefore there will be deserts. So such deserts of the world are located away, not necessarily they are located only in the trade wind belt. They are located, they can be located anywhere, but they are located on the leeward side of the high mountains. Or generally ye deserts milte hai in the regions between 35 to 65 degree north and 35 to 65 degree south. And we call such deserts as the mid latitude deserts. So kaun sa hai mid latitude desert in India? Thar desert is a desert of which is located in the trade wind belt. Kalahari, trade wind belt. Sahara, trade wind belt on the western side of the continents. Atacama, trade wind belt on the western side of the continents. But Leh Ladakh is a mid latitude desert. Why? Southwest monsoon cannot cross the Himalayas. Taklamakan is a mid latitude desert. The Gobi desert is a mid latitude desert. Patagonia desert, cold desert, is a mid latitude desert. So aise questions aate hai, that is the mid latitude deserts are located in on the leeward side of the Western Ghats, the mid latitude regions are the regions of deserts. Consider the following statements. They are located in the trade wind belt on the western side. They are located on the leeward side of the mountain. हम deserts मतलब हमें लगता है पहला ही point हम वो mark करके आएंगे और जब answer की आएगी तो हमें realize होगा. Key point is hot deserts, western side. Mid latitude deserts, leeward side. They are known as mid latitude में गर्मी होगी या सर्दी होगी. सर्दी होगी. Therefore they are known as an cold deserts. ऐसा ही question एक test series में भी आया था आपके proper मतलब जो main test series है उसमें. Mid latitude deserts are found where, that is, they will change the words and they will ask you some kind of an questions here. The third characteristics of pehla direction, second rain windward and the leeward belt, third characteristics of the orographic rainfall is mountain kahan pe located hai. That also plays a very very important role. If the mountain is located near the coast, versus if the mountain is located in the inland. Coastal mountains, even if they are of a lower height, rainfall will be heavy. But inland mountains, to cause a rainfall, it has to be of a greater or even the higher height. Why? Because till the time, this is already with moisture, thoda bhi upar rise hua, it will give heavy rainfall. But till the time it reaches the interiors, most of its moisture is lost. So bottle mein pani already bahut kam hai. So when it is less, you will have to compress the bottle more. So similarly, wind has already lost its moisture. Till the time it reaches Himalayas, it has to rise up more to give rainfall. So inner mountains such as Himalayas has to be of a greater height. So what kal prelims mein question aayega ki have Himalayas had been the same height as Western Ghats, kya hota India? India would have been a semi-desert or a desert. Kaisa desert hota? Cold desert or hot desert? Dono. During the summer season, we would have been hot desert. And during the winter season, Mongolia se, China se cold winds would have come and we would have become a cold desert. So Iran ka, India ka climate would have been same like Iran. Iran is both a cold desert and a hot desert. So India would have been both. It is the because of the Himalayas, we are not a desert country. We are a monsoon country. And the last and the most important characteristics of orographic rainfall is orographic rainfall does not require season. It can occur in any season. Convectional rainfall will occur only in the summer season, except at the equator. Equator mein to kabhi bhi ho sakti hai. Orographic rainfall ke liye kya zaruri hai? Onshore winds, not offshore. Wo kabhi bhi ho sakta hai. Onshore wind coming in the winters, it will give the rainfall. Onshore winds coming in the summers, it will give the rainfall. So it is not season dependent. So therefore, world mein sabse common rainfall or maximum rainfall is orographic rainfall. The maximum amount of rainfall in India is also orographic rainfall. Getting it? Cherrapunji Mahasvandram, orographic. Northeast India, entirely orographic. Cherrapunji Mahasvandram ko cross karte Himalayas aate hain. Again, the wind is forced to go up. So, orographic rainfall. Western Ghats, orographic rainfall. Dandakaranya, Patplatu, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, orographic rainfall. Getting this? So, these are the key points regarding the orographic rainfall, and we will do some of the map-based questions also regarding the, are you carrying the atlas? Don't open abhi. You can take down orographic rainfall. Sorry. Orographic rainfall. The rainfall that is caused due to the mountain barrier. The rainfall that is caused due to the mountain barrier. The rainfall that is caused due to the mountain barrier is orographic. For orographic rainfall, following conditions are necessary. For orographic rainfall, following conditions are necessary. First, the mountain should be perpendicular to the wind direction. Mountain should be perpendicular to the wind direction. Because the air should rise up, comma, cool adiabatically. And give rainfall. Example, Western Ghats. Konsa side of Western Ghats? Western side or Eastern side? Western side. On other hand, as Aravallis are parallel to the southwest monsoon, as Aravallis are parallel to the southwest monsoon. Parallel to the southwest monsoon. They do not act as a barrier. They do not act as a barrier. And therefore, western side of Rajasthan is desert. And therefore, western side of Rajasthan is desert. And therefore, western side of Rajasthan is desert. Getting this? So, India mein desert kyun hai? Because consider the following statements regarding Thar desert. Agar kal question aata hai. First, it lies in the trade wind belt. True or false? True. Southwest monsoon is what? Trade wind. Second, it lies in the subtropical high pressure belt where the air descends. So, it is not between 30 to 35. Thar desert, India, maine kaha, India is exception in climate. हमारे यहाँ पे भी डेजर्ट है जस्ट लाइक सहारा थार डेजर्ट बट एक भी रीजन वो ट्रू नहीं है द मेजर डेजर्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बिकॉज दे आर लाइंग ऑन द इन द सब ट्रॉपिकल हाई प्रेशर बेल्ट वेयर द एयर इज फोर्स टू कम डाउन एंड सेकेंडली दे आर वॉश्ड बाय कोल्ड करंट्स यहाँ पे पाकिस्तान है ओशन नहीं है फॉर कोल्ड करंट्स टू कम सेकेंडली वी आर नॉट इन द हॉर्स लैटिट्यूड्स हॉर्स लैटिट्यूड हमारे ऊपर है बट स्टिल राजस्थान इज अ डेजर्ट बिकॉज ऑफ उसका डायरेक्शन डायरेक्शन ऑफ द अरावलीज अरावलीज आर पैरेलल सो देयरफॉर द ब्लैक कलर साउथ वेस्ट मॉनसून विंड कम्स एंड इट गोज पैरेलल टू द अरावलीज एंड डायरेक्टली रीचेस द हिमालयस इसलिए कौन सा अरावलीज का माउंट आबू में सिर्फ माउंट आबू में बाकी के जगह नहीं अगर विंड भी आती है तो प्रेसिडेंट हाउस के इतना ज़्यादा हाइट पे है Aravallis pe hi, we are right now on the Aravallis. This ridge road is nothing but Aravallis. Ye orographic rainfall cause karega? No. Kahan pe air upar ja rahe? It is more like a speed breaker for the wind. Upar se niche chali jayegi. Fine? It is not like, so understanding why Rajasthan is a desert? Because ek to common hai, it is in the trade wind belt. India pura trade wind belt mein hai. Exception is western disturbances. Otherwise, India totally lies in the trade wind belt. वो तो वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंसेस हमें जेट स्ट्रीम ले आती है हमारे पास सेकेंडली अरावली इज अ दिस थार डेजर्ट इज बिकॉज इट इज ऑन द अदर साइड दैट इज द बिकॉज ऑफ द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द अरावलीज गेटिंग इट सेकेंड पॉइंट एक ही रीजन है अरावलीज आर पैरेलल टू द मॉनसून क्या फिर पाकिस्तान ये पंजाब चिल्लाएगा पंजाब में तो हो रही है बारिश पाकिस्तान चिल्लाएगा सो पंजाब तो चिल्लाएगा दिस विंड्स आर गोइंग एंड हिटिंग हियर दिल्ली चिल्लाएगा उत्तराखंड चिल्लाएगा अगर यहाँ पे आपने वॉल बना दी तो इट इज नॉट चाइना वी आर डेमोक्रेसी चाइना अगर होता तो एक वॉल अगर उनको लगता कि राजस्थान ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है और दिल्ली ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं दे वुड हैव कंस्ट्रक्टेड अ वॉल एंड इट वुड हैव कॉस्ट द रेनफॉल बट ऐसे नहीं हो सकता वॉल बनाओगे तो इंडिया में करप्शन इतना है कि वॉल वो पूरा एक सिटी के ऊपर गिर जाएगी एक नेक्स्ट पॉइंट द इन द ओरोग्राफिक रेनफॉल इन द ओरोग्राफिक रेनफॉल There is a maximum difference between the leeward and the windward side. Maximum difference of rainfall between the leeward and the windward side. Windward क्या होगा? ज़्यादा rain. Leeward less rain. The leeward side receives. The leeward side receives less rainfall. The leeward side receives less rainfall due to the rain shadow effect. due to the rain shadow effect of the mountain barrier. Hence, iska example one, first example. The narrow strip running parallel to Western Ghat. On its leeward side. Is drought prone. Because of the rain shadow effect of the Western Ghat. Example two. The rain shadow region of the tallest mountains in the world. Is desert because of the inability of the winds to cross this mountain barriers. The famous mid-latitude desert region are one, Patagonia Desert. Due to the rain shadow effect of the Andes. मैं लिखाऊंगा नहीं, but concept याद रखना, ये westerly winds है यहाँ पे, and therefore they cannot cross the Andes. Second, Leh Ladakh Desert and the Tibetan Plateau. Due to the rain shadow effect of Himalayas. Third, Taklamakan Desert of China. I guess we have marked this also earlier. Taklamakan Desert of China. Nahi mark kiya? Taklamakan Desert of China. And Gobi Desert of Mongolia. कौन सा यहाँ पे कुनलुन शान, तैन शान, अल्तुन शान, पूरा ये ट्रांस हिमालयस का पार्ट, बहुत सारे माउंटेन्स है ये. So these are the mid-latitude deserts of the world. 1, 2, 3, and 4. This is Patagonia Desert. So India mein 3 desert region hai. 2 desert region hai. Hot desert due to the Aravallis. Rain shadow effect nahi. Parallel nature of the Aravallis. While cold desert is due to the rain shadow effect of the Himalayas. While this is a semi-arid, drought-prone region due to the rain shadow effect of the Western Ghats. Rain shadow effect of Western Ghats. This is drought-prone due to the direction of Aravallis. Agar Aravallis par parallel nahi hoti, to this would have been a rainy region. This is cold desert due to the rain shadow effect of Himalayas. मैप के लिए याद रखना द टू एग्जाम्पल्स विच आई एम गिविंग. यहां से मैप बेस्ड क्वेश्चन आते हैं. देयरफॉर मैप के लिए देयरफॉर मुंबई पुणे, मुंबई पुणे, मुंबई पुणे एंड मैंगलोर बैंगलोर and Mangalore Bangalore Mangalore Bangalore though are geographically nearby have very high difference in rainfall. Very high difference in rainfall. Why? Mumbai and Mangalore are in on windward side. Pune and Bangalore are in leeward side. Pune and Bangalore are in the leeward side. So Mumbai is at the foothills, Mangalore is at the foothills, Bangalore and Pune are on the leeward side. Isliye Mumbai and Mangalore mein 250 centimeters of rainfall, Bangalore and Pune mein 50 centimeters of rainfall. Difference of the rainfall is 200 centimeters. Kilometer mein difference hai unka 180 kilometers. But rainfall ka difference zyada hai. Hum uska abhi hum pehle likh lenge, fir location dekhenge. Next, that diagram is important, India wala. जैसे बनता है क्लास में वैसे बनाने की आदत करो. ऐसे सोचो कि घर पे जाके मैं क्लीन बनाऊंगा, नहीं होगा. घर पे जाके यू विल नॉट ओपन द लैपटॉप. इवन इफ यू ओपन द लैपटॉप बहुत क्लीन बनेगा डायग्राम, बट वो रिप्रोड्यूस नहीं होगा इन द एग्जाम. वी आर मेकिंग समथिंग विच वी वॉन्ट टू रिप्रोड्यूस इन द एग्जाम. सो आंसर लिखते लिखते ऐसे हाथ घूमने की आदत पड़ जाएगी, इंडिया बन जाएगा. Don't worry about the world map that much. It is not going to make that much difference. Theek hai. Can I continue? Next. The location of a mountain is important. The coastal mountains of lower height can cause heavy rainfall, example Western Ghats. But the inland mountains, such as Himalayas, should be of greater height to cause rainfall. Rainfall always is greater near the foothills of the mountains and decreases away from the foothills. Decreases away from the foothills. Isme example. Understanding this? Foothills ke paas hamesha rainfall zyada hoga. If you go away from the foothills ke paas hamesha rainfall zyada hoga. Air is forced to rise up. If you go away from the foothills, rainfall will decrease. Therefore, example, rainfall is greater in Dehradun as compared to Delhi. Rainfall is greater in Dehradun as compared to Delhi. Dehradun as compared to Delhi. And last characteristics. Orographic rainfall can occur in any season. Orographic rainfall can occur in any season. This is your past year question. थोड़ा मैं past year questions को modify करता हूँ, so that now you know the answer is C. Understanding what they are checking? Aise questions jab hum dekhte hain in the exam, past year questions, ye mat sochna ki hame India ke har ek city ka rainfall yaad hona chahiye. They don't even expect you to know ki Delhi and Jaipur mein kitna difference hai rainfall. You should know the concept. Windward side, leeward side. All other these are in the plain region. So rainfall will be difference between Delhi and Jaipur. Kitna 10 centimeters ka. Varanasi and Kolkata have a rainfall ka difference, but that rainfall ka difference, Kolkata, is it in the mountain barrier? No. So it gets somewhere around 150, 190 centimeters. Varanasi gets 100 centimeters. Mumbai, Pune, 200 centimeters ka difference hi hai. Allahabad, Patna, same amount of rainfall. So just always look at the geographical location. Fine? So with this, open the map. Map of India, the first page. Political map of India. First page in the political map of India. So, page number 11. See, we worry about the questions which came this year, ki Bangalore ke same latitudes pe kya hai. Now, the students who had done geography earlier, ye Raus mein QEP hota tha, QIP, Quality Improvement Program. Ab hum yahan pe Quality Enrichment Program kar rahe. So this, in that Quality Improvement Program, we had done this question and luckily it came in the exam. That is, I had asked the students to do the map of the major cities. Yahi question karte karte, and I showed them the map of Bangalore and told them, see, surprisingly, you'll see Bangalore, Bhopal and Delhi are in the same latitudes. UPSC ne question pucha, Delhi and Bangalore. Usne Bhopal cancel kar diya. You can see Bangalore, Bhopal and Delhi are in the Shimla bhi hai upar, are in the same latitudes. Longitude. So Nagpur thoda side mein hai. Nagpur Hyderabad hai. Nagpur and Hyderabad are in the same longitude. So can you see Bangalore ka location? Can you see Mangalore ka location? So important cities jo humne dekhna hai, Mangalore, Western Ghats. Dekha? Bangalore on the leeward side of the Western Ghats. Got this? So, if you now, surprisingly, if you go to the north, Bangalore ke baad aata hai Bhopal at the same latitude. Abhi kar lo. Bangalore ke baad aata hai Bhopal at the same latitude. And Bhopal ke baad aata hai Delhi. Longitude, not latitudes. Longitudes. Delhi ke baad aata hai Shimla. So these are four at the same longitudes. Fine with this? No, Mangalore, not Mangalore. Bangalore, Delhi, Bhopal and Shimla. Fine? Ab you see, Bhopal is a city which is very near to the Tropic of Cancer. Yeah, it is a city which is on the Tropic of Cancer. Yes. Near to the Tropic of Cancer. Remember this. Getting it? Now, the second surprising thing is, if you go from Delhi to the eastern part of India, you will see Gangtok and Delhi are at the same latitudes. Delhi ke same latitude mein we have Sikkim and we have Arunachal Pradesh. Arunachal Pradesh bhi same latitudes pe. Dekha? Itanagar is also at the same latitudes. Question aata hai UPSC ka, identify a place in India, a state in India, which is located at the same latitudes as Delhi, Jaipur, but has more than 80% of area under forest. Hum sochte option rehta hai Arunachal Pradesh, hamara dimag, kyunki we are not familiar with the map, hum sochte hai Arunachal Pradesh to upar hoga, we mark Nagaland. Kyunki ek option UPSC Nagaland bhi deti hai. Understanding this? So, jaise is saal Nagpur mark karke aaye bahut log. So, this is because we don't study these basic maps. Gangtok, more or less same, similar nahi, similar latitude, similar is pe hai, exactly same pe to Bangalore bhi nahi hai phir. Thoda bahut nearby hai, UPSC hamesha puchhegi nearby, कोर्ट केसेस अवॉइड करने के लिए, क्योंकि 1 डिग्री का तो डिफरेंस होगा ही. देन कम बैक टू द बैंगलोर, कम बैक टू बैंगलोर. You will be surprised to see that Bangalore is to the south and Chennai comparatively is to the north. Chennai थोड़ा north में है and Bangalore comparatively south में है. अगर atlas देखते समय कभी भी ऐसा confusion हुआ तो best thing is go to the index and look at the latitudes and longitudes of the cities. Everything is given in the atlas पीछे. The cities का latitudes and longitudes has been given here. Fine with this? Same नहीं है. Bangalore is to the south and Chennai is to the north. Fine with this? And come back to Chennai again. You will be surprised to see Chennai and Allahabad are at the same longitudes. यूपीएससी पूछेगा विच सिटी लाइज एट द सेम लॉन्गिट्यूड एज चेन्नई. एक देगा कोलकाता, एक देगा अलाहाबाद. आप सोचोगे कोलकाता, दोनों ईस्ट में है. अलाहाबाद और लखनऊ, सॉरी सॉरी, नॉट अलाहाबाद, लखनऊ. आई एम सॉरी, अलाहाबाद इज नियर रायपुर. दिल्ली एंड लखनऊ, देखो कैसे लगता है. लखनऊ तो सेंट्रल इंडिया, चेन्नई इज ईस्ट कोस्ट, हो ही नहीं सकता साथ में. सो दिस आर सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स. ऐसे हम जब इंडियन ज्योग्राफी करेंगे तो, बट कीप ऑन रिवाइजिंग दिस, नहीं तो याद नहीं रहता. एक हफ्ता और, एक हफ्ता और. What? वो हम इंडियन ज्योग्राफी में करेंगे. Fine. जैसे और एक है, बिकॉज इफ यू आर हैविंग द मैप एक्स्ट्रा ओपन, एक और पॉइंट मैं बता देता हूँ इंपॉर्टेंट, विच इज द ईस्टर्न मोस्ट स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया. ईस्टर्न मोस्ट स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया, अरुणा, आई गेस वी हैव डन दिस ऑलरेडी. ईस्टर्न मोस्ट एंड द वेस्टर्न मोस्ट स्टेट. वेस्टर्न मोस्ट स्टेट ऑफ इंडिया इज गुजरात. वेस्टर्न मोस्ट कैपिटल ऑफ इंडिया, स्टेट का कैपिटल, गांधीनगर और मुंबई. किया है हमने ये मुंबई. और एंड द ईस्टर्न मोस्ट कैपिटल ऑफ इंडिया, कोहिमा, नॉट अरुणाचल का कैपिटल, कोहिमा नागालैंड का कैपिटल. So when we say the cyclonic rainfall, we say the cyclonic rainfall is of two types. One which occurs in the temperate cyclones and one which occurs in the tropical cyclones. When we say temperate cyclones ka rainfall, it is further of two types. Which occurs along the warm front, it is gentle. Which occurs along the cold front, it is heavy. Abhi sirf itna yaad rakhna. Kal tak ye pura clear ho jayega, because for understanding fronts, for understanding cyclones, we should first know fronts. For understanding fronts, we should first know air masses. Air masses is the next topic once we finish this. And tropical cyclone ka precipitation, you already know. How is the tropical cyclone ka precipitation? It is a natural disaster. Kabhi suna hai, UK mein people died because of cyclone? Europe mein nahi, but it is very common in India, it is very common even in USA, even in Japan, even in China, tropical cyclones. They are natural disasters. One of the most powerful of all the natural disasters. Fine with this? Can I rub this? So this is the last topic of climate, air masses, fronts, cyclones, cyclone disaster management in India, and anticyclones. Fine? But this is very, very important topic both for prelims and mains. We have question last year on air masses. We always have a question on cyclones. Agar paper 1 mein nahi to paper 3 mein cyclone disaster management in India. This year we had a question on thunderstorms, which is a kind of an cyclonic circulation. We had a question on heat waves. So this is the part jisse har saal ek question to aata hi hai. So what is an air mass? Any idea what is an air mass? Form of air. Column of air. See, air mass technically is huge body of air, three-dimensional. Huge body of air. Vertical bhi hai, horizontal bhi hai. Covering a large area. But, ye sabse important hai, having uniform properties or same properties. Uniform properties across its ka horizontal expansion. Means horizontally, the properties are uniform. Ab horizontally, how the properties can be uniform? What are the properties of air? Either it is cold air or warm air. Because temperature. Temperature will determine pressure. Pressure will determine uska humidity. Temperature and pressure will determine uska humidity. So we say air mass is a huge body of air or a large body of air which has uniform horizontal, which has uniform properties across its horizontal length and more or less uniform across its vertical column. But what is more importantly is the horizontal. So with this, have you understood everyone the concept of air mass? With this I am asking you, why do we study air masses? To understand fronts. Why do we study fronts? To understand cyclones. Land and water body. Parcel of air. Parcel of air, second parcel. Third parcel. Fourth parcel. and, for example, fifth person. So is one satisfying our definition? Huge body of air having horizontal properties across its, or having the same properties across its horizontal expansion. Horizontally property same hai ki nahi? Yes. Is second an air mass? Khud socho, is second an air mass? Horizontally will the second body of air have same property? No. Some of it will be humid, some of it will be dry. So second is not an air mass. Third? Yes. Totally on the land. Fourth? No. Some part on the land, some part on the water body. And fifth? Yes. That means there are only few places in the world where the air masses can originate. This can be wide areas of the oceans or very, very wide areas of the continents. Continents may be specifically, this is not an air mass then. Because if the continent is not flat, then the air will have different properties at different height. So this is not. That means air masses can originate in the continents jahan pe we have very, very flat, wide land, Canada and USA. Understanding? Siberia, Russia wala region. Sahara Desert. Getting it? And some parts jahan pe land is very wide is equator, Brazil wala ye region. If you remember the South America ka map. This is area where, which is very, very wide. But air masses cannot originate at the equator because at the equator, air is not constant. Air masses ke liye air has to be constant. If this air is at the equator, what will happen? This air will rise up. And therefore, air masses cannot originate at the equator. The best area of the origin of the air masses is where the air is constant. That is the subtropical high pressure belt or the equatorial high pressure belt. Jahan pe the air is coming down. So based on this, we have 16 types of air masses. 16 types of air masses. Yahan tak GS hai. And each and every air mass in detail is optional. So hum sirf classify karenge how many types of air masses are there. Why air masses are important? Example, if this is where you are staying, if this one air mass comes to your region, will it give rainfall? Yes, because it has taken moisture. So air masses are important because they influence the climate of the area. Ab kya hai air mass? Nothing but wind, but which has become stationary over an area for a sufficiently large amount of time ki us area ki property le leti hai. So that is what is an air mass. For example, if the air is moving with great speed over Delhi, so versus there is one air which becomes stagnant for 3 or 4 days over Delhi. So what will be the air mass? Air mass will be the second because it remains stagnant and jo Delhi ka temperature hai, wo air ka temperature ban jata hai. So air mass, for air mass to continue, to mature, it has to remain stagnant over a place for sufficiently long period of time. Generally, 3 days lagte air ko to take the pressure, temperature of that area. Air masses are important because when cold air mass and warm air mass converge, they result into formation of fronts. And fronts will result into formation of cyclones. Understanding this? So air masses is bit technical. In fact, to tell you very frankly, I was surprised jab pichle saal GS mein air masses pe question pucha. Because air masses is core optional. That is, for example, plate tectonics pe pucha, koi bhi kitna bhi difficult question, we can understand. But geosyncline theory kabhi nahi puchhenge of Himalayas in GS. So वैसे ही jet stream पे आने दो जितना भी difficult, cyclones पे आने दो जितना भी difficult, but they generally do not cross the boundary. The एक imaginary boundary जो होता है कि ये optional का है, ये GS का है, experience के साथ जो. So air masses was on the optional side. Mantle plume was on the optional side. इसलिए मैंने आपको convectional current ऊपर से बताया, but आपको डिटेल में नहीं बताया, because never thought कि मेंटल प्लूम जैसा डिफिकल्ट टॉपिक विल कम इन GS. air masses, so yes, a difficult topic will come in GS. But still, if you look in NCRT, air masses are there, so you should know. NCRT mein Köppen bhi hai, Thornwhite bhi hai. That I am guaranteeing ki kabhi nahi aayega in GS. Because Köppen and Thornwhite classification are those jo optional wale bhi bhagwan bharose chhod ke jate. That is, they don't understand this classification. Ye agar aayega to they will not attempt that question. So obviously GS mein kabhi nahi aayega. Aur agar aata bhi hai, तो फिर वो सबके लिए ही गुप्ता न्यूमिस्टैटिक्स आर्ट्स जैसा क्वेश्चन बन जाएगा विच नोबडी विल अंडरस्टैंड. सो वैसे दैट आंसर इज गिवन इन 9th एनसीईआरटी ऑफ हिस्ट्री. एक लाइन क्लास वाले क्लेम करेंगे सब कुछ एनसीईआरटी से आता है. एक लाइन और 200 वर्ड्स इज डिफरेंट. सो यू कैन टेक डाउन एयर मासेस. अ ह्यूज बॉडी ऑफ एयर. A huge body of air having uniform properties, having uniform properties in the terms of temperature, in the terms of temperature, pressure, in the terms of temperature, pressure, and humidity. Horizontally, temperature, pressure, and humidity, horizontally, and to some extent, even vertically, but what is more important, horizontally, is known as an air mass. For air masses to originate, following conditions are necessary. One, there should be homogeneous area of either land or sea. There should be an homogeneous area of either land or sea. Second, the atmospheric conditions should be stable, so that the air takes up the properties of the area where it develops. Air takes up the properties of the area where it develops. Next point. Hence, the air masses will never develop. Air masses will never develop. In the regions of equatorial low pressure belt in the regions of equatorial low pressure belt. Because the air is unstable, in the regions of equatorial low pressure belt, because the air is unstable. The air mass after originating, takes up the properties of the region where it takes up the properties of the region Next point, for air mass to take up the property, it should remain over the region for minimum 3 to 4 days. ये एग्जाम में मत लिखना, दिस इज फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड. ये जो रीजन वाला 3 से 4 दिन वाला. नेक्स्ट, दस देर आर वेरी फ्यू रीजन्स इन द वर्ल्ड where the air masses develop these regions are known as the source regions and the इम्पॉर्टेंट सोर्स रीजन्स आर. देखो वैसे 6 है, हमें सारे करने की जरूरत नहीं. इम्पॉर्टेंट सोर्स रीजन्स आर कोल्ड कॉन्टिनेंटल एरियाज ऑफ कैनेडा एंड रशिया. Second, cold maritime regions. In the Pacific and Atlantic Ocean. Next, vast subtropical and tropical interiors. Vast tropical and subtropical interiors of Arabian and Sahara Desert. And the tropical regions of Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Ocean. Atlantic, Pacific and Indian Ocean. तीनों को मैंने एक ही नंबर दिया है, 666. That is Indian Ocean, Atlantic and Pacific Ocean. Vast region. You see, this is vast. यहाँ पे air mass technically develop होना चाहिए, but it will not develop because it is in the equator. So कहाँ पे है? Canada, Atlantic, Russian, Siberian region. ये Central Asia पूरा आएगा इसमें. The Indian Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Pacific Ocean, but higher latitudes में. ये cold है, ये warm. Cold, warm, warm. Tropics में warm, warm. Fine. So these are the source regions of the air masses. Next, on the basis of temperature, on the basis of temperature, the air masses are divided into, one, cold air masses, right in the bracket, small k. Cold air masses. Cold air masses. कौन सा होगा cold air mass? ये सारे cold air masses, but definition देखो क्या है cold air masses का. Cold air mass मतलब whose temperature is lesser than the area it visits. That is a cold air mass. So अगर इसका टेम्परेचर ड्यूरिंग द विंटर्स बिकॉज ऑफ एक्सट्रीम स्नोफॉल, यहाँ का रीजन इज -40, यहाँ पे विंटर्स में द रीजन कैन बी 5 डिग्री सेल्सियस. एक्चुअली बहुत कोल्ड है, बट हु विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ कोल्ड एयर मास इफ सेकंड गोज इन द एरिया ऑफ 4, कोल्ड एयर मास. बट इफ 4 कम्स इन द एरिया ऑफ सेकंड, देन इट इज एन वार्म एयर मास. गेटिंग इट? अब जब सेकेंड गोज इन टू द एरिया ऑफ 4, विल इज दिस एयर ड्राई एयर और मॉइस्ट एयर? ड्राई. सो ये रेनफॉल देगा? नो. सो दिस विल कॉल एज स्टेबल एयर मास. बट थर्ड, इफ इट इज कमिंग ड्यू टू जेट स्ट्रीम्स, अंडरस्टैंडिंग जेट स्ट्रीम्स, इसके ऊपर जेट स्ट्रीम है, सो दे आर ऑलवेज गोइंग टू द वेस्ट, फ्रॉम वेस्ट टू ईस्ट. ऐसे नहीं आएगा, यह हमेशा ऐसे जाएगा, बिकॉज इसके ऊपर विच जेट स्ट्रीम इज देयर? Polar jet stream is there, 60 to 65 degree latitudes. So if 3 goes in the area interior, wo barish dega? So you will call this as unstable air mass. Getting it? So cold air mass whose temperature is lesser than the area it visits, cold air mass means whose temperature is lesser than the area it visits, warm air mass, symbol is small w. Whose temperature is greater than the area it visits. Air mass whose temperature is greater than the area it visits. Example, southwest monsoon is an example of warm air mass. क्या है एग्जैक्टली साउथ वेस्ट मानसून? और पांच, मतलब वंस वी फिनिश दिस एयर मास, हुज टेम्परेचर? ये है साउथ वेस्ट मानसून, विच इज इन द सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर, टेक्स अप मॉइस्चर, बिकम्स हॉट एंड ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम क्रॉस द इक्वेटर एंड ड्यू टू कोरियोलिस फोर्स ये पूरे इस एरिया में आएगा एज साउथ वेस्ट मानसून विंड्स. पहले ये पूरी ये हवा यहाँ पे जाएगी, बट तब तक इक्वेटर आ जाएगा. अगर अफ्रीका थोड़ा भी नीचे होता तो ये एयर सीधा निकल जाती, बट यहाँ पे इक्वेटर है, वंस इट क्रॉसेस द इक्वेटर इट विल गेट डिफ्लेक्टेड टू द राइट. नहीं, इट इज ग्रेटर. लेटेंट हीट ऑफ कंडेंसेशन, इट इज हैविंग लेटेंट हीट इनसाइड, मॉइस्ट हीट, इट इज नॉट लेसर. आते आते वो गर्म हो जाता है, समर से यहां से शुरू हो गए, बहुत ज्यादा गर्म हो जाता है बिकॉज ऑफ लेटेंट हीट. नेक्स्ट, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ओरिजिन, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ओरिजिन द एयर मासेस कैन बी, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ओरिजिन द एयर मासेस कैन बी स्मॉल सी, कॉन्टिनेंटल एयर मास, स्मॉल सी, कॉन्टिनेंटल एयर मास, स्मॉल सी, स्मॉल सी से डिनोट करना है. कॉन्टिनेंटल एयर मास कैन बी वन, कॉन्टिनेंटल एयर मास लिखना स्मॉल सी उसके अंदर. कॉन्टिनेंटल एयर मास स्मॉल सी क्या होगा? कॉन्टिनेंटल एयर मास वन विच ओरिजिनेट्स ऑन द लैंड, कॉन्टिनेंटल एयर मास वन विच ओरिजिनेट्स ऑन द लैंड. One which originates on the land. And second, maritime air mass, small m, small m, one which originates on water bodies. वाटर बॉडीज, वाटर बॉडीज मतलब ज्योग्राफी में लेक या नदी नहीं, ओशंस. ओके, सो व्हाट इज सेवन? मैरीटाइम, वन कॉन्टिनेंटल, फाइन. सो एक स्टेटमेंट कोरियोलिस फोर्स, इक्वेटर क्रॉस करके क्या है कोरियोलिस? In all, there are 16 types of air masses. In all, there are 16 types of air masses. In all, there are 16 types of air masses. जो हम कल करेंगे, ठीक है?